It's only the fourth month of the year, but there is so much positives to warm our hearts. So let's count down on the top 5 positives of this month. Here are the top 5 positive news stories of April 2021. Before we begin, please show us some love by liking our video, subscribing to our channel, and hitting the bell icon to receive notifications for upcoming positive listicle videos. Number 5. Hero trucker ignores own safety to save utility worker stuck in a bucket with fire blazing below. A trucker was at the right place at the right time to become a hero when he rescued a utility worker who was trapped in a raised bucket truck which had caught fire below. With just minutes to spare before the truck exploded, a police officer ran over a tractor trailer that was stopped at a nearby intersection. The driver, Efrain Zepeda, sprang into action, moving his trailer beneath the Santa Rosa, California utility worker without care for his own safety to provide the man with a means of escape. Amidst plumes of black smoke and flames, the worker was able to jump down onto the truck and evade serious injury or death. Zepeda works for Estes Express Lines, which praised their driver's actions and his heroic efforts. Number 4. Students design skateboard wheels made from chewing gum. Chewing gum is a type of plastic pollution that we are just not talking about enough. Most modern chewing gums are made from synthetic plastic polymers that don't break down or biodegrade. That means when you toss your used chewing gum on the sidewalk or stick it underneath a bench, you're littering. Not only that, but chewing gum is commonly mistaken for food by wild animals, especially birds, causing them to choke or die. Two design students from the L'École des Designs Nantes Atlantique in France are imagining ways to combat the silent pollution problem creatively. Hugo Maupetit and Vivian Fisher have created a concept that turns used chewing gum into skateboard wheels. They got the idea while brainstorming for a design-focused way to tackle the gum pollution issue in urban areas. The idea is to bring the gum from the streets back to the streets in a sustainable way. The students envisioned a fictional partnership between Mentos, one of Europe's biggest chewing gum producers, and Vans Europe, a popular manufacturer of skateboarding shoes and accessories. The students' project proposes a line of vibrant skateboard wheels sold by Vans that uses old gum collected from the streets. How would they go about collecting the gum? According to the students, Mentos would install gum boards in urban areas to help spread the word and inspire passerbys to stick their used gum to the signs instead of tossing it elsewhere. The gum would then be cleaned, molded with a stabilizing agent, and stained with natural dye to form the base of the wheels. Number 3. Returning the love, frat brothers pay off mortgage for their house cooked 30 years later. A group of Louisiana State University fraternity brothers have always said their fraternity house cook was like a mother to them. So when they found out she was working two jobs to pay off a mortgage, they stepped in to get the job done. Alumni of Phi Gamma Delta surprised the former cook, Jesse Hamilton, with $51,765 ahead of her 74th birthday in a celebration on April 3rd that they dubbed Jesse Hamilton Day. During a time at the Fiji house from 1982 to 1996, Hamilton, a single mother of three, would start her days at 4 a.m. to get to campus in time to serve the boys breakfast, lunch and dinner, while also being a listening ear who'd drive them to the grocery store or to doctor's appointments. Over the years, Hamilton stayed in touch with several brothers, including Andrew Fusciotti, now 52, and the owner of a car dealership in Mobile, Alabama. At the start of the pandemic, Andrew, who attended LSU in the late 80s, called Hamilton and was reportedly disheartened to hear she was still working two jobs as cleaner at the Baton Rouge Metropolitan Airport and as a cook at a country club. After speaking with her children, he learned that she had 16 years left on a 30-year mortgage and needed $45,000 to pay it off. Soon he had his fraternity brothers on board, and in the end, 91 brothers donated an average of $560 each to make it happen. Together, Andrew and his brothers, all of whom are vaccinated, presented Hamilton with a check to cover a mortgage and a second check of $6,675 to spend on herself. They celebrated a birthday with a celebration in the driveway of a Baton Rouge home. Hamilton was grateful when she received the checks. Hamilton said she plans to retire and enjoy retirement from the comfort of a paid-off home. When it's safe to travel again, she also hopes to visit Hawaii. Number 2. France proposes handsome financial incentives for trading old cars for electric bikes. The French government is planning to give citizens who want to trade in their old cars a £2,500 grant towards the purchase of an electric bike. The notion has been approved by lawmakers at the National Assembly in a preliminary vote and is part of a more ambitious round of emission cuts planned for 2040, at which point the French government hopes to have reduced them 40% compared with 1990 levels. The French Federation of Bicycle Users told Reuters that if adopted, France will become the first country to offer such a trade, all in an effort to reduce the number of cars on the road, especially the ones that produce more emissions. The decision by France was hailed by green lobbying and cycling groups who see bikes as a major solution to combat vehicle emissions. Number 1. Rail worker who saved child from a train now donates half his reward money to boy's family. After saving the life of a little boy who fell on the tracks, an Indian railway employee went viral for his kindness on the internet. Now he's being praised once again, this time for giving the boy's family money the Ministry of Railways gave him as a reward. Though he has his own family to take care of, when 30-year-old Mayur Shelke was given 50,000 rupees from the ministry in a special ceremony, he decided he'd donate a good portion towards the education of the very child he saved. As news of Shelke's newest act of selflessness spread, his name once again began trending on social media, with many praising his kindness and good spirit. Earlier on April 17th, a small boy who was holding his mother's hand was making their way across a railway platform. Weighed down by a heavy burden on her back and hampered by limited vision, she lost a grip. The child tumbled onto the tracks just as an approaching train barreled towards the station. But in the blink of an eye, Shelke scooped the child to safety, hoisted himself onto the platform a split second before the locomotive thundered past and a tragedy was averted. Shelke said that he ran towards the child but also thought that he might be in danger too. Still, he thought that he should save him. It's an old saying, but it feels particularly true when thinking of Shelke and his selfless deeds. True heroes really don't wear capes. Multiply the positivity by sharing these sweet stories with your friends on social media. Like, subscribe, and hit the bell icon to get notifications for upcoming positive listicle videos.